So I would say the most memorable crime scene that I worked on was an industrial accident. Somebody picked up a lawnmower and it wasn't supposed to turn on, and then it did turn on and their fingers were severed. So I went to the scene to take photos and collect evidence, and then I also went to the hospital to take photos of their hand and the tips of their fingers that had been severed off. I was just there to collect evidence for the purposes of court, so if they do decide to go to court, then they have my photos. My name is Tamryn Loy Son, and I work as a forensic identification assistant with the York Regional Police. I attend crime scenes and collect, preserve, and document evidence. So I do break and enter, assault, recovered stolen vehicles, domestics, that kind of stuff. So a typical day, we arrive at the office, we check the queue, which would have any calls that we need to attend to. So what we attend to are called SOCO calls. So if an officer attends a scene, they will call for a SOCO call if they need us to attend. So then we'll get into our work vehicles. And there are computers in the work vehicles, much like officer cars. And then we will go to the calls and assess what needs to be done. So generally, any case that we do is strictly confidential until it has been put before the courts and has been resolved. So we generally don't talk about our work outside of the agency. I just attended court to speak to the photos that I took, to confirm that all the photos that they had for the court case were taken by me or someone that I knew. And then I had to, for injury photos, point out where the injury was and circle it. We do have practice in school, so we had a mock court in our last year. But it's very different when you are actually on the stand and have to talk, and there's a bunch of people looking at you, and the accused is sitting right across the room from you, so it's pretty intimidating. Due to the nature of the work, it can be stressful. Sometimes you get to see really horrific car crashes or people that have been in hard times, so people in domestic disputes and that kind of stuff. You kind of just take it one day at a time, and there's lots of resources if you need help. So I applied to UTM in high school to go to the forensic science program, which is a general first year, which everyone does, and then you apply in second year to be in the forensic science program. All the different specialties will lead to different kinds of jobs. Biology would be blood analysis and DNA, that kind of stuff. And chemistry would be paint samples, chemicals and arson, or that kind of stuff. And then anthropology would be bones and determining what happened to the body after they had already died. And then psychology is more the people that go to the jail and assess whether somebody that's already incarcerated is mentally ready to be reintroduced into regular society. Of the four specialties, I liked chemistry the most, so I went into chemistry. A forensic chemistry degree is a chemistry degree with extra courses that are focused on forensic science. So UTM has a crime scene house that is on campus, so most of our mocked crime scenes happen there, and they'll set it up with a dummy and footwear and blood and that kind of stuff, and then we go in after the fact to process the scene. So I guess I was drawn to forensics because I do like problem solving, and I felt like it was an area where you could give back to the community through your job. York is the first municipal police agency to hire civilians to do this job. The hiring process for the York Regional Police is a 5-step program, and it starts with the questionnaire and then a test of knowledge, so things forensic related, then an interview, and then a psych eval, and then a house visit. So overall, that took 9 months. I would say the forensics degree gives you an edge over someone that just has a science degree, because you already know about all of the procedures and that kind of stuff that needs to be done for evidence that's going to court. So if you're considering a job in forensic sciences, I would probably make sure that you can see some of the more graphic images that we see in real life. So if you are very queasy when somebody gets a cut, that might not be the ideal path for you. Some of the soft skills that would be needed are interpersonal skills, since you're going to be talking to people that are victims of crime. So you're going to need some empathy to understand what they've been going through, and maybe patience to make sure that you aren't pushing them too hard because you're now asking them for more things after they've already experienced something traumatic. And writing skills, since you're going to be writing notes continuously all the time to document the scenes of crime and what you've been doing at the crime scene. You can contact our office to get a tour. Unfortunately, you can't job shadow just because of the safety reasons, but you can come down and like see the lab and see what everyone does. Some of the techniques are really fun to do, like blue fuming stuff is fun, and dusting can be fun. Some of the cases that we do, it's nice to see when they are resolved. I also find it rewarding to be able to help people in domestic incidences. So if there's domestic abuse, my photos can be served as evidence that the assault had happened. I can't watch Criminal Minds anymore because it freaks me out, because I live by myself and almost always their victim is like a young 20-something female that's like 120 pounds or less, and I'm like, oh my god, it's always me. My mother's always worried.